当民主党2020全代会正式确认党内总统候选人提名资格，拜登要上从政40多年生涯最高峰之际，川普早已备好拆台大戏。
China will own our country if he gets elected. They will own our country, and we're not going to let that happen. And you've seen the intelligence reports. China very much wants Joe Biden to win.
This is just the way of the world. China is an economic rival to the United States. It does export, it does manufacture, and yes, it takes American jobs.
We want to see China rise. China is going to eat our lunch. Come on, man. I mean, they're not bad folks, folks.
Did you talk about China or your deal with China?
No.
A 12-hour flight over?
No, of course not.
That never came up?
No.
Less than 2 weeks after that trip, BHR Partners was launched, a private equity firm funded in part by Chinese banks.
川普阵营砸下7位数美金，大买数位广告时段发动闪电战，在一连4天民主党全代会期间，全力播放广告攻击拜登。除了描绘他对中国过于宽容，次子杭特是靠中国赚钱的奸商，还暗示拜登年老智衰不宜执政，便有美国媒体看过影片后感叹：2020不亚于2016的性别攻击，市场更龌龊的抹黑乌贼战。
And in addition to that, we have to make sure that we are in a position that we are, you know, the rapidly rising
民主党全代会闭幕日，川普转为深入拜登出生地宾州，向当地主要人口蓝领阶级细数拜登出卖他们的旧账，直指他一旦当选，美国将重演经济噩梦。
Biden supported every single globalist attack on Pennsylvania workers, NAFTA, China's entry into the World Trade Organization, which built China into a power, TPP.Korea, the horrible, ridiculous Paris Climate Accord, which stripped our nation of its energy, and the so-called Clean Power Plan. The only good thing about it was the name. It was a horrible, unfair deal. Horrible for you and horrible for Pennsylvania.
连日来，川普现身多州造势，反制对手，夺取媒体焦点，但攻击内容不见新意，凸显出的是危机感。毕竟拜登确定搭档贺锦丽后，全国性民调依然稳定领先，显见组合具加分作用。
Pull them up, our brand new NBC News Wall Street Journal poll. Let's dig into those numbers. You see that Vice President Biden has about that 9-point lead when you look at the race in that national perspective. That's a lead that's being mirrored in some other polls from other networks that we've been seeing.
但全国性民调的落后，只能解释川普比起拜登确实不受选民欢迎。美国总统大选独步全球的选举人团制，两党铁票仓早已底定下，都让入主白宫的关键落在摇摆州的输赢上。川普近来频在中美问题上做文章，两人差距明显拉近。就连向来反川普的有线电视新闻网 CNN， 至今仍不敢。定论大选最终谁胜谁负。
Right, if you look at the nationwide average, it's Biden by 9, right? But then you look at Michigan, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, Florida, Arizona. These are the 5 closest states that Trump won in 2016, and Biden needs to win at least 2 of them. And if he doesn't win Florida, he needs to win at least 3 of them. And what you see right now is a state like Wisconsin, Florida. Those are the 2 most important states because he needs to win one. Michigan and Pennsylvania together.Don't add up to enough electoral votes. So the race nationally, in my mind, is actually closer to, say, a 6-point margin than necessarily the 9-point margin.
川普仍有保住政权可能，却挡不住共和党内越见茁壮的反叛势力。前国务卿鲍威尔、前俄亥俄州州长卡西奇先后录制影片现身民主党全代会，以国大于党的理由力挺拜登出任总统，成为最大惊奇。前国土安全部官员泰勒也称，在见证川普的糟糕治理后，选择支持不同党的拜登。
We would go in to try to talk to him about a pressing national security issue, cyber attack, terrorism threat. He wasn't interested in those things. To him, they weren't priorities. But the president wanted to exploit the Department of Homeland Security for his own political purposes and to fuel his own agenda. I came away completely convinced based on firsthand experience that the president was ill-equipped and wouldn't become equipped to do his job effectively. And what's worse, was actively doing damage to our security.
一波未平，一波又起。川普前国师班农许久不见镜头前，引来媒体大阵仗拍摄，竟是遭纽约联邦法庭指控，利用边境筑墙发动网络募捐，取得$1,000,000，但部分落入个人口袋作为开支，有诈欺选民之嫌。班农出庭不认罪，川普第一时间立即切割。
Well, I feel very badly. I haven't been dealing with him for a long period of time. I let my opinion be very strongly stated at the time. I didn't like it. It was showboating and maybe looking for funds. But you'll have to see what happens. I think it's a very sad thing.
年前，班农一手打造川普竞选主轴，不但推动边境筑墙论，也鼓吹美中贸易战，强打关税牌。四年后，边境牌已经失灵，但反中牌仍活跃于本届选战中。川普与拜登间选情依然紧绷下，似乎带着班农的影子继续挥动反中牌，抓住连任的一丝希望。